فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. My beloved brothers and sisters, we're in the sharh of the kitab التحفة السنية بشرح المقدمة الآجرومية written by محمد محي الدين عبد الحميد رحمه الله تعالى. We were in the نيابة الفتحة عن الكسرة. That's where we were last lesson. We were on the نيابة الفتحة عن الكسرة. And we were speaking about the ism, which is what we call al-mamnu' min al-sarf. And we mentioned that the mamnu' min al-sarf is of two types. Who can remind us of what it was? Alamiya is wasfiya, like, does anyone know how we first categorized it before we got into alamiya and wasfiya? Yeah? Hey Abbas. Lafzi and? Lafzi and Ma'nawi. We spoke about that, na'am, last lesson. And we said that there is, the mamnu' min al-sarf is two types. Number one is that which has two illatan. And we said the illatan are alamiya and wasfiya. And then we said there's one that's illa wahida, only has one defect. And we spoke about alamiya from the ones that had two illa, two defects. We finished all alamiya. Today, inshallah ta'ala, the second one that we're going to be speaking about is what? Al-wasfiyya. And then after that, we're going to go to the second branch of mamnu' min al-sarf, which is illa wahida, the one that has only one defect. And the one that only has one defect are two. One is muntaha, sighatu muntaha al-jumu', which we'll speak about. And the last but not least is the one that's al-makhtumu bi alif al-ta'nith, which we'll speak about inshallah ta'ala. So I want all of you to pay attention inshallah ta'ala and give your ears to me bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. Al-wasfiyya is what we're on. So we spoke about what wasfiyya means, what alamiyya means. We're going to now go into al-wasfiyya. What does wasfiyya mean? Alamiyya, we said, it's a alam, it's a name. Wasfiyya basically means it's a description. It's a wasf. So if it's a sifa, the thing, if it's a description, it is prevented from tanween and it's also prevented from kasra because of it being what? لِلْعِلَّةِ الْوَصْفِيَّةِ, because it's illa of wasfiyya, right? And this illa is a illa ma'nawiyya, right? This is not tangible. And the nuhat mentioned is three of them. The first one is ziyadatu alifi, wa-nun. For example, atshan. Atshan and jaw'an. Atshan means what? So atshan means what? What does atshan mean? Thirsty. Atshan is a what? It's a description of how you are, right? Huh? So atshan is what? Mamnu' min al-sarf. Sah? It's mamnu' min al-sarf. Uthman is mamnu' min al-sarf, right? What's the difference between Uthman and atshan? Uthman is a alamiyya. And this one is what? Wasfiyya. Both of them, like, can have what in agreement? What do they both have in common? They both have ziyad alif and noon. Sah? They both finish alif and noon at the ending. Alif and noon. Sah? عطشان جوعان huh? جوعان means what? Hungry. So جوعان is a hungry, is a name, right? Or it's a description. Huh? It's a description. So جوعان is what? عثمان, لكن we mentioned it in the علامية that we were speaking about. That's the first one. زيادة ألف والنون. The second one, remember we spoke about this before, that the علامية and the وصفية, both of them, the فعلة is because it's a فرع. So the صفة is a فرع of what? The موصوف, the thing that's being described. It's a فرع and it's a branch from it. Remember that. Keep that in mind. We mentioned that last lesson. Number two, ووزن الفعل. ووزن الفعل كأفضل وأحسن. For example, the Sheikh here mentions, for example, أكرم, أفضل, أجمل. All of these are descriptions. They are wasf, but they come in the form of a verb. صح? They all come in the form of a? They all come in the form of a verb. That's a وزن فعل. Very good. All of them are, look, أكرم, أفضل, أكرم, sorry, أفضل, أجمل. All of them are what? They are all وزن الفعل. They come in the وزن. وزن means what? Yeah, the pattern of a verb. But it's a description. And the third one is وصفية. مع العدل. This is one's عدل. عدل means what? عدل in simple terms, it means that the اسم معدول عن الاسم الآخر. عن الاسم الآخر. The عدل means that this name is taken معدولا به عن وزن آخر. It's taken from another وزن, another pattern. Like for example, we already spoke about this before, we mentioned it. Where Umar is taken from, and Zufar, and Qutham, and Hubal, and Zuhal, and Jumah, and Quza', and Mudar. We mentioned all of them, right? That they're taken from. So the name Mathna is originally taken from what? Mathna is taken from Ithnain. Mathna is taken from Ithnain, Ithnain. And Thulath is taken from what? Is taken from ثلاثة ثلاثة. Good. ثلاث. So ثلاث is taken from ثلاث ثلاثة. أخر, أما أخر is taken from, sorry, أخر. أخر is taken from what? آخر. It's taken from what? It's taken from آخر. The reason why it can't accept كسرة as a جر is because you're dealing with something that's changed. You want to go to the original. The original can accept it, but not this one. Because this one is changed from its form. It's changed from its form. Those are three, just like we took last lesson, they are ممنوع من الصرف. So if you ever find a description in the Arabic language that finishes with alif and noon at the ending, wherever you find it, and it's in a موضع الجر, you make it مجرور بالفتحة and not مجرور بالكسرة. If you find a wasf, a description in the وزن of أفعل, in that form أفعل, what do you do to it as well? مجرور بالفتحة. And if you find مثنى وثلاثة ورباع وأخر, all of them, if you find them, what do you do? You مجرور بالفتحة. If somebody asks you what's the reason, you just say ممنوع من الصرف. If they ask even more, what do you say? وصفية. If they ask even more, you say عدل. That's all it is. Now the Shaykh رحمه الله, he goes into that which has إلا واحدة. That which has إلا واحدة. Does anyone have tissue? I went Subways once. Jazakallah khairan. We're now going to go into that which has illa wahida. It has only one illa. صيغة منتهى الجموع Now we go into the last one, which is that which has look at the Sharh Muhammad Huddin Abdul Hamid's kalam in the Kitab Tuhfat Sunniya. He says, وَأَمَّا الْعِلَّتَانِ اللَّتَانِ تَقُومُ كُلُّ وَاحِدَةٍ مِنْهُمَا مَقَامَ الْعِلَّتَيْنِ فَهُمَا صِيغَةٌ مُنْتَهَى الْجُمُوعِ وَأَلِفُ التَّأْنِيثِ الْمَقْصُورَةِ أَوْ الْمَمْدُودَةِ. So he said, there's one that's illa wahida. It's only got one illa, one defect, but it can take, and it's equal to the one that has illatan. The one that we mentioned before, the one that has illatan, which is illa al-alamiyya and wasfiyya, right? It can take its place, okay? The illatan, sorry, was what? Lafdiyya and ma'nawiyya, sah? It can take both of its places. And there were alamiyya and wasfiyya, we spoke about that, the nine. This one's equal to that nine by itself, which is the one that has illa wahida, it only has one illa. And that is sighatul muntaha al-jumu' and al-makhtum bi alif al-ta'nith. Look what he says after that. Amma sighatul muntaha al-jumu' fadabituha. This is what you need to memorize and you need to know. The first one. سيغة منتهى الجموع. What is it? What's the ضابط for it? ضابط means what can you restrict it and really understand and know its reality. Okay? أما سيغة منتهى الجموع فضابطها. سيغة منتهى الجموع is أن يكون الاسم جمع تكسير. That this noun is جمع تكسير. It's a broken plural. وقد وقع بعد ألف تكسيره أما تكسيره حرفان نحو. It falls after what? This is all you need to memorize. أن يكون الاسم. That this noun is جمع تكسير. It's a broken plural, number one. وقد وقع. And after it fell what? وقد وقع بعد ألف. After the ألف, there happened تكسيره حرفان. It's تكسير two letters, such as مساجد. منابر أفاضل أماجد أماثل. Anything that comes. It means in simple terms, anything that comes in the form of مفاعل. Anything that comes in the wazn of what? Anything that comes in the wazn of مفاعل. So we have what? This one is مساجد. Pay attention here. We have alif. We have alif here. Two letters fell here. صح? And this one has a kasra here. That was the dabit. That's what he mentioned to us. صح? In this situation, you say, ذهبت إلى مساجد. Say مساجد. Are you there? Masajida, you say. You can't say masajidi. No. We're going to talk about. There are two conditions, though. There are two times where it's an exception. It's a hal istithna'iyya. It's an exceptional situation where you actually have to put a kasra there. Yeah? That's what we're not going to start. That's why he doesn't accept it. This whole chapter, that's what it's about. The whole chapter is that the kasra doesn't show. What shows is a fatah is what shows. Huh? That's the whole point we're talking about, right? The reason we're explaining why does it take a fatah instead of a kasra. Are we all together? Does that make sense? Huh? So it, in simple terms, anything that comes in the form of what? In this form. Mafa'ila. Anything that comes in that form. Just remember that form. Anything that comes in that pattern, that wazn, that scale. Mafa'ila. Look at this. Masajida. Remember that. You keep that in mind. Manabira. Mafa'ila. Form. Same. Afadila. Huh? Came in the form of mafa'ila. Amajida, amathila. It comes all in that form. Does that make sense? Very good. Is that it? La. There's another one, Sirat al-Muntaha al-Jum'ah. That's one. I only mentioned what? I mentioned one, which is Sirat al-Muntaha al-Jum'ah. The first one is mafa'ila, anything that comes in that one. The second one is Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid tells you, he says it to you, wa amathila. وخوائض وطوامتا وطوامتا sorry that's it أو ثلاثة أحرف وسطها ساكن or three letters the middle one is what has a سكون in it meaning three letters after the ألف not two this time three. Are we together? And it has a sukun in the middle of the third one. In other words, this time it comes in the form of mafa'il. It comes in the form of mafa'il. The sukun is in the third one. After the alif, there's three. One, two, and three. The middle one of the three has a sukun on it. That's the second type of Sirat al-Muntaha al-Jum'ah. Are we together? Here is mafatihan, qanadil, and etc. Yeah? And asafir. All of those are siratul muntaha al-jumu'. Anything that comes in those form, you make them what? Huh? You make them mamnu' min al-sarf, and you say that it's what? Majroorun bil-fatha. If somebody asks you, what's the reason? You say, illa wahida. They say to you, what is it? Siratul muntaha al-jumu'. And it's in the form of mafa'il. Mm-hmm. This is the last one. Makhtum bi alif al-ta'nith. Bi alif al-ta'nith. This is another one. Remember we mentioned how many forms does the mu'annath come into? We mentioned it last week. Last week's class. We said that the mu'annath can be what? The mu'annath can be ma'nawiyya, it can be a meaning. Like Zainab. Zainab doesn't have anything that says that's a female. But we know meaning-wise that this is a woman, Zainab. Sah? Are we all together? That's one. The second type is that which is... Second type of mu'annath we said is what? Huh? That which finishes with what? Huh? That which finishes with ta' marbuta. It's a word which is mu'annath. Like what? Aisha, Fatima, Hamza. All of these names are what? The word is مؤنث. It's got ta' marbuta. Are we all together? And then we spoke about the third type, which is what? This one, which is that it's مؤنث بألف التأنيث. Remember? Remember when we were speaking about the first one which had علتان, two علّة, two reasons. What was the first one that we mentioned from the عالميّة? What was the first one? تانيث بغير ألف. It's مؤنث, but not with ألف. Why did we leave the ألف? The ألف is left for here. So Zainab and what do you call it? تامربوطة. Both of them are in there. In the illa, which is alamiya, it's up there. And this place, which is illa wahida, it brings the what? It brings here the mu'annath, which is ta'neeth, is the alif of ta'neeth. That's not in alamiya. Does that make sense? And there are two types of alif of ta'neeth. One that's mamduda, and one is that which is maqsura. The Shaykh gives you an example of one that is mamduda, like hamra, hasna. Hasna is a mu'annath, صح? Hasna, look at that. It's got alif, which is mamduda. Alif mamduda is the alif that stands. صح? Okay, and an example, Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid mentions money for you. Hamra'an, da'ja'an, and bayda'an, kahla'an, nafiqa'an, even ulama'. Sah? All of those is what? What did it have? Al-makhtum bi-alif al-ta'neeth, which is akin mamduda. Then we have maqsura. Maqsura is like what? Hubla. Hubla. صح? Quswa. Huh? That's alif, but it's maqsura. It's called alif maqsura. Those are all mu'annath now. So you say, hubla. Quswa and da'wah and claiming and stuff like that. Those are what? Alif maqsura. Alif which is maqsura. Very good. Those are mamnu' min as-sarf as well. They are what? They are mamnu' min as-sarf. They are what? Mamnu' min as-sarf. The reason is because al-makhtumu bi alif al-ta'neeth. لكن it's illa wahida, it's only one illa. It's only one reason. And the reason here is maqtub bil alif al-ta'neeth. We finished the mamnu' min as-sarf. But before we move on, there are conditions that Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid did not mention. No, he does mention it. He says it here. Go. He says it. ويشترط لخفض الاسم الذي لا ينصرف بالفتحة أن يكون خاليا من أليف وألا يضاف إلى اسم بعده. فإن اقترن بألف أو أضيف خفض بالكسرة نحو قوله تعالى وأنتم عاكفون في المساجد ونحو مررتم بحسناء قريش. محمد محي الدين عبد الحميد mentions that the mamnu' min as-sarf that we mentioned, the mamnu' min as-sarf that we just mentioned, for it to apply, the mamnu' min as-sarf for it to apply, for in other words, for it to be majrur with what? For it to be majrur bil fatha, two conditions have to be absent from it. Two things shouldn't happen to it. An yakuna khaliyan min alif, it should be absent from having alif in it. It can't have alif in it. Remember we wrote masajid. If it becomes al-masajid, then you have to place a kasra there. As Allah said in the Quran, وَأَنْتُمْ عَاكِفُونَ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ. Why? Because it's مُعَرَّف بِالْأَلِفِ وَاللَّامِ. It's got Alif and Lam in there, صح؟ وَأَنْتُمْ عَاكِفُونَ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ. Good. The second one is that it can't be مضاف إلى اسم بعده. It can't be attributed to a name after it. For example, مررت, I went by, بحسناء قريش. بحسناء قريش. The beauty of Quraysh. Does that make sense? Hasna here is attributed to what? I went by the individual Hasna, the one from Quraysh. صح? She's been attributed. In other words, simple terms, it has to be munakkaran. It has to be indefinite. It can't be definite word. The word becomes a definite word, then it becomes what? It has to be what? It has to be indefinite. If it becomes mu'arraf, then it becomes مجرور بالكسرة. مجرور بالكسرة. So for example, you say to them, this condition applies on all of them, by the way. It applies on every one of them. What about if I say, مررت بأحمدكم. I went by your Ahmed. See what I said? مررت بأحمدكم. Ahmadi, صح? Did you see what I said? An example, say, what did we say Ahmed was? What's Ahmed? ممنوع من الصرف, right? Why is it ممنوع من الصرف? Yeah? What's the reason in the beginning? It's عالمية. And which one? Which of the nine عالمية? Which of the six of عالمية? Is it وزن فعل, right? أحمد وزن فعل. أحمد وزن فعل. So what did you say? I said مررت. Look at this. مررت بأحمدكم. مررت بأحمدكم. Here, there's a ba which is حرف جر. And I told you before. That Ahmed is ممنوع من الصرف, اسم الذي لا ينصرف, صح? So it shouldn't accept a kasra. But here it did accept a kasra. Why did it accept a kasra? Because the last word is Ahmed, right? Why did it accept it? Because the kum is here, which is made the idafa, right? I attributed Ahmed to you guys. I said, I went by your Ahmed. So if it's mudaf, mudaf and mudaf ilay, then you place a kasra there. Okay? If I say, marartu bil Ahmed, okay? So I say مررت بالأحمد. مررت بالأحمد. بالأحمدي is what I say, okay? Because why? What did I put in there? Alif and Lam. Are we all together? Some of you now are wondering, can you put an Alif and Lam inside a name? And the name, the asal of it is that it's what? It's already mu'arraf. Sahih? It's already a mu'arraf. So why does the alif, we'll come to that inshallah, in mutammimatul ayah jurumiyah, inshallah. That will come to us. In mutammimatul ayah jurumiyah, inshallah ta'ala. I'm going to give you guys one beautiful benefit, inshallah ta'ala. Are you guys ready for it? Yeah? I never had anyone respond. Is it me or no one wants it? Yeah? Only some of you want it, huh? Who thinks it's going to be hard to remember all of that information I mentioned? Who thinks it's going to be hard to remember it? Huh? It's a lot of information, huh? Right now it's harder. What about if I give you a line of poetry? Would you memorize it to remember it? Yeah? That summarizes everything I mentioned. One line, I said. Will you memorize it? Huh? You guys will, huh? We need to give a lot of importance to what's memorized, okay? If you guys memorize it, it will stick. Do you guys agree? Okay. Let's write this, inshallah ta'ala. A summary of everything that we mentioned in Mamnu' min al-Sarf. As in, not the details and explanation, but just each type what they were, okay? So what I wrote was إِجْمَعْ وَزِنْ عَادِلًا أَنِّثْ بِمَعْرِفَةٍ رَكِّبْ وَزِدْ عُجْمَةً بِالْوَصْفِ قَدْ كَمُلَى. Ibn al-Nahas is the person who said this. Who said this? Ibn al-Nahas. He's the one, this is all the majmu' al-ilal, all the reasonings. So inshallah, let's try to read it together. I'll say, you guys say after me. He said, إِجْمَعْ وَزِدْ عَادِلًا أَنِّثْ بِمَعْرِفَةٍ رَكِّبْ وَزِدْ عُجْمَةً بِالْوَصْفِ قَدْ كَمُلَى. هذا هو. If you memorize those all, they're all in there, right? If you just take a picture of it, trust me, it's better you write it on your own hand. Let's take the last and alamat al-i'rab today, which is al-jazm, and then inshallah ta'ala we have finished the chapter of ma'bab ma'rifat alamat al-i'rab, and the next week inshallah ta'ala I will test you with the khulas of this bab. I will test you on the summary of this chapter, small little summary. If you can write it for me, I'll put a little test together for you guys next week inshallah. Just test if we understood the previous chapter before we move on. Okay, we're now going to move on to the statement of Al-Imam Ibn Ajurrum, where he says, Alamata al-Jazmi. We're going to go to Alamata al-Jazmi. He says, Walil Jazmi Alamatani As-Sukunu wal-Hadfu. As-Sukunu wal-Hadfu. This chapter, what has gone? What is not in this chapter now? Al-Asma' are not in here. Remember in Jar, when we're talking about Af'al? When we're speaking about Khafd, this whole chapter, Mamnu' min al-Sarf, when we're talking about verbs at all, did verbs come in? No. All of it was nouns. لأن the Jar is a unique sign of what? Listen. It's alama. A sign that is unique to a ism. Very good. Here, on the other hand, we're going into what? We're going into al-jazm. And jazm is a unique sign for who? It's a unique sign for the fi'l. It's a alama khasa. It's a alama which is unique. Dalil af'ali for the verbs only. So we won't be talking about anything other than what? Anything other than a verb. What is it that we're going to discuss here today, inshallah ta'ala? So here it is, inshallah ta'ala. I'm going to draw the diagram. Okay. Remember what we said about the fi'il mudari'. What was it that we said about the fi'il mudari'? We said that the asl of the fi'il mudari', the default position is that it's marfu', right? The asl is that the fi'il mudari' is what? Marfu'. Sah? The only time that the fi'il mudari' moves away from raf' is either if adawatul jazmi enters it or adawatu an-nasb. But other than that, the fi'il mudari' by the default position, by its natural position, is that it's what? Marfu'. It can only be moved from the raf' when it's what? Some external things have to enter it. So if adawatul jazmi, which are inshallah ta'ala what we're going to take soon, if they go before the fi'il mudari', what do they do to it? They make it majzoom. So, and the way that the jazm is expressed by the fi'il is of two types. Okay? The only fi'il that we're discussing here, by the way, is only fi'il mudari'. Madi and amar are both mibni. They have no place in this whole chapter. Okay? So let's put the word lam here. What can come after lam is what? It's only fi'il mudari'. So let's say lam yal'ab. The word originally used to be what? Yal'abu, right? It used to be what? It used to be yal'ab. Yal'abu. This is what it used to be. Yal'abu. That's how it used to be. When lam came, which is from the terms, from the words that they go before the fi'il mudari' and they force it, this is what it does to it. It places. So this is called, and inshallah we're going to take it later, they're called adawat. Adawat are what? Words, letters that are basically jobbed is to make the fi'il mudari' majzoom. That's what they do to the fi'il mudari'. So here, lam yal'ab is what we say. Why do we say yal'ab? Why is it sukoon at the ending? Because this fi'il is a mudari', which is as-sahih. I didn't write that. I don't know why I didn't write that. Yeah, I was meant to write al-mudari' as-sahih. Sorry about that. It's a what? It's al-mudari' which is sahih. Al-mudari' that's healthy. There's no problem with it. When we say sahih, the last letters, none of them are waw, alif, or ya. Sah? None of them are waw, alif, or ya. So yal'abu is a ba at the ending. So the sukun shows. So we say majrurun. وعلامة جره السكون صح صح that's what we say. Here the issue arises now. What about if the fi'il is not healthy from the back or the ending? What about if it does have a waw or an alif or what? It doesn't have a ya or a ya at the ending. What does it? What? Like for example, give us an example, Abdurrahman. Okay, I will. The example here is the word yaqdi. Sah? The word yaqdi. Is yaqdi a fi'il mudari'? The answer is yes. Yaqdi is a what? It's a fi'il mudari'. Is it sahih al-akhir? Is it healthy at the end? The answer is no. Why? Because it's got a then. At this point, what happens is that the lam wants the sukun to show, and the fi'il which is mu'tal, the fi'il mudari' which is ill from the end, the way that it expresses the jazm is by hadf. Hadf here means what? You remove the harf illah. So how do we know, sah, that what was removed was not a waw or an alif or a ya? How do we know? When the way to know it is, it will be yaqdi. This kasra shows you that what was taken out is a sah. Okay, yad'u. What was taken out? Fatullah. Yad'u. Lam yad'u. What was taken? Lam yad'u, you said. What does it sound like? Sounds like a waw, right? This shows you that what was taken out is a waw. This shows you what was taken out is a? It's taken as a ya. وَهَلُمَّ جَرَّى. And if it's alif, the sign is going to be a fatha. صح? Are we all together? Does that make sense? So this is the first, this is, I explained this one for you, and I explained this one for you. صح? Are we all together? If it's healthy from the ending, you place the sukun at the ending. That's it. يلعب يقتل يضرب. That's what you say. But if it's ill from the ending, how do you say? You remove the harfu illa and you bring the adawatul jazmi there. And you remove the ill letter. That's why it's hadf. You do hadf. Another time hadf occurs. Second time the hadf occurs is when it's amthilatul khamsa. Again, the word yal'abu. But remember we took amthilatul khamsa, af'alul khamsa. What is af'alul khamsa? Fi'l mudari' that finishes with what? Alifu lithraini, awawu al-jama'a, or ya'il mu'annathati al-mukhataba. We said that, right? So you say yal'abuna, sah? That's how it was. Yal'abuna. Wawu al-nun at the ending, right? Huh. How does it show? Huh? How does it show in this situation? What do you remove? You remove the noon. That's it. You just remove the noon. What do you say? لم يلعبوا. You say, صح? That's it. You remove the noon. الحذف here means a حذف noon. Does that make sense? Any فعل مضارع that finishes with plus. So any فعل مضارع. This is a فعل مضارع, right? يلعبوا is a فعل مضارع. صح? It is. And then after it came what? واو الجماعة. Oh, ألف الاثنين. Like يلعبا. Oh, يا المؤنثة المخاطبة. تلعبين. So you say لم تلعبي. لم تل عبي. That's what you say. Does that make sense? Am I making sense? That's the خلاص of علامتا الجزم. The two علامة of جزم. Yeah. This alif is another reason. We want to go into it. The reason why the alif comes, because now you might ask me, why, where is the alif from? We'll come to why they put an alif there. But this right now is not our job. We just need to focus that the noon has been taken. Bit by bit. Does that make sense? So we've managed to finish the alamata al-jazm. Alamata al-jazm. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.